Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Erin Phalo. Topping our news, a fatal fire in Derry, which is now under investigation this morning. Firefighters say that a woman died last night in a fire at a home on Bypass 28. A man survived the fire and is now recovering in the hospital. Crews say they had a difficult time reaching the victims due to hoarding conditions. Fish and game officials say a man from Ringe died yesterday while hiking the Wapak Trail in Sharon. They say 66-year-old John LaSorsa collapsed while hiking with his son. He was pronounced dead at the scene. A child at the center of an Amber Alert is safe this morning. Police say the boy's father, 33-year-old Jeremiah Grant, abducted his 18-month-old son from his home in Somersworth yesterday afternoon. Grant was arrested in Maine, where he is a registered sex offender, early this morning after leading police on a chase. He's now being held on a fugitive from justice charge. Police say Grant will be extradited back to New Hampshire, where he faces charges including a felony count of interference with custody. For the second time this week, a Manchester clerk came face to face with a robber last night, but this time he fought back. Surveillance cameras captured the masked man jump over the counter at AA Market while wielding a knife. Seconds later, you see him hop back over and then run right out the door. That's because the clerk pulled out a bat. That clerk is convinced this is the same robber who held him up on Sunday and got away with cash.
I was sitting over there, and he was over here. And telling me, you know, what's the drill? And I told him I exactly know what is the drill. I went after him middle of the block between Hanover and the Hall.
This morning, the masked man is still on the loose. Manchester police strongly urge cashiers to not fight back, saying it could cost them their lives. The Magic Mile is roaring to life in Loudoun with NASCAR getting ready for Sunday's big race. The drivers arrived yesterday with huge crowds hoping to catch a glimpse. The 5-hour Energy 301 isn't until Sunday, but practice starts at 11:30 this morning, and there is a full slate of action all day long with the Xfinity Series Lakes Region 200 tomorrow. The New Hampshire Motor Speedway is celebrating 25 years of racing this year. That does it for us. Thanks for joining us and have a great afternoon.